the end of the first period. It's Philadelphia 2, Atlanta 1. We'll be back with our recap and intermission activity. Oops, let's stay right here, as now we've got Kelly and Ken Houston, and they're all off the bench at center ice. Everybody piled in.
Oh, you're going to know this is good. Everybody's up sky high for this game here, as it means the second place in the Patrick Division. Couldn't see what started, but Bob Kelly and Ken Houston are making threatening gestures toward each other, but Houston, a lot bigger than Kelly in height. Houston goes 6'2", Kelly's about 5'11", but nothing's going to seem to come of it, but you can bet your boots that the final 40 minutes of this hockey game is going to be a gangbuster.
All right, let's give it again. The end of the first period, the Philadelphia Flyers 2, the Atlanta Flames 1. We'll be back.
At each other and throwing the punches. Rick LaPointe has a good hold of Eric Vail. That could erupt into something, but everybody's on the ice, sticks and gloves everywhere, and it all started with Willie Plett and Dave Hoyta really had a good set to while we were away, and they've finally broken those two up. Now Kelly and Houston, who are going to start this whole thing off just at the end of the period. It seemed to have calmed down. Then Hoyta and Willie Plett started throwing punches. Now Houston and Kelly have got a return match going right now. Everybody's all milling around in front of the penalty box, and everybody is out. Dave, except the two goaltenders, Bernie Perrott and Danielle Bouchard, standing at the fringes watching everything go on. But boy, tempers are really high tonight here at the Omni against these two teams.
But I tell you, the fights that we've had have been bell ringers. Wilson and Plett, Hoyta and Plett again, who's cut up, as he was getting good punches in, but hitting the top of the head, it appeared, on Hoyta because of his height, and Hoyta seeming to ring the bell in on Plett's face.
Well, you can see the subject. Willie Plett really throwing some good right hands. Hoyta throwing some over the head, but it's the sweater. The sweater is getting pulled up over Hoyta's head, and Plett really landed some good, strong right hands when the sweater is up over Hoyta's head. And, you know, a lot of players will have their sweaters tied down to the back of their pants so that another player cannot do that. And exactly what happened, the Flyers do not have many of their sweaters tied down. And
well, we almost went the first time, and then we held, and everybody started skating off their respective benches or the exit ways. And then just seconds after we left, boom, it went with Plett and Dave Hoyta. And then later on, just as we came back, it was Kelly and Houston. But there are a lot of other pairings brewing out there.
Wally Harris will have to get a little notepad and pencil to write down all the players involved. But what a fight between Willie Plett and Dave Hoyta. Boy, oh boy, I'll tell you, Plett landed some, about four or five real good right hands on Hoyta, but Hoyta never went down, stood up, and gave a few good ones back himself.
All right,
everything's quieting down now.
Side of the ice, and after the team's break,